Oh, yeah, yeah.
Kind of.
Yeah.
Canning Tan.
Oh no, we're not going out. We need to get a train.
I am lost in my own city.
Would you believe it? Hold on for a second. Oh wait, last time I came here, it was a while ago, but I remember this.
Welcome to
ExCeL. Alright mate, calm down mate.
Welcome to
You have the stage.
Welcome to ExCeL London. At ExCeL London you can find various shops on the left side and the right side.
Lost.
Ice cream van down there.
You abuse your stage.
If you're interested.
Where? Yeah.
A trip of coffee, that's kind
of... Oh shit, there's a staircase here too. Literally nowadays, whenever I see them, I get gas.
Shouldn't be too difficult. People think.
What was that, 4 or 5? Yeah. Alright, all done now. We can head into ExCeL London. Let's do it. We're here at ExCeL London. F***ing finally.
Yeah. On the right hand side, you have an S3.
There's entrance.
Yes.
Please enjoy.
Right, so finally here, I'm here with CT. Huge buzz here. Lots going on. We've just got here, it's about 12:30. I'm gonna go and try and find Rush and Gigi right now and see how they're getting on, man, and yeah, just check it out. In the Elevate event.
Yeah.
Just taking a second to try and, because there's so much going on, we're just trying to figure out what to do first. It's 12:30, things going on until 5:30, so we've got 5 hours. there's so much shit to get done, so much shit to see, so many to speak to. So yeah, just figuring out where to go first, kind of thing. There's a few conferences, a few seminars as well, which will have, I think it works like every hour someone comes to speak about something fitness related. So those things you need to make time for if it's something you want to hear about. But other than that, you've pretty much just got people around with their stools set up. You just got, so there's just a bunch of stools set up. Yeah, you just go over, speak to people, and yeah, it's just really about just speaking to as many people as possible with this sort of thing, and you know, trying to learn as much as you can about the whole fitness space, that sort of thing. Everyone's pretty cool here. Everyone, I think, wants to meet people at a networking event like this, so people are quite receptive and quite cool. So yeah, I try to get down to these things as much as I can.
I found Rush.
Yeah, I know that, and I think the A1's up. So we're gonna go check out Rush in a little bit, but I just wanna make sure we're not missing anything that's like time sensitive. Is that sweat? I'm sweating.
Yeah, when you're skipping.
Oh yeah. If you haven't seen that video, I saw a set of stairs outside the building, and naturally I just felt the inclination to skip. So I don't know if I've plugged the video in yet, and if I haven't, here it is now.
Oh shit, there's a staircase here too.
Winning. But yeah, I want to make a little kind of video series out of it and start visiting different locations in London and doing that. So stay tuned for that. That's going to come pretty soon. We're just in the process of getting locations scouted and making time for it, so look out for that. It's going to be pretty cool. There's going to be an aspect of it where we're just engaging with members of the public, chatting to people. We've done a couple already, haven't yet released them, but it's been fun, so I'm excited to see what that becomes in the long term. Alright, I'm going to stop talking now and try and figure out where I want to go. The problem is, I've just skipped up a bunch of stairs, right? I'm sweating. I know that if I go to Rush right now, it's going to make me skip. And I'm like, oh, give me a moment, give me a second, right? Give me a second to catch my breath back. So, yeah, really just want to make sure we're not missing out on anything.
So, yeah, you had the Theragun, which literally just shoots a little ball repetitively,
shoots it
into your back. And that's just a form of like stress relief from muscles and tight muscles. That's such a sick idea.
How does it feel?
How was it?
Fantastic. Amazing.
I remember that time I got lost in the zoo, fam. Let's bring back memories.
In the zoo?
Yeah. Do you remember that time I got lost in the zoo? I was crying next to some gorilla. I was just chilling there, because then I went to the flipping.
Where
that I went to the...
Where did I go?
I went to the lost and found bit, and it just kept me there until my mum came, and then I stopped praying.
Medication and being unhappy and just stuff like that and what I was going through. Basically was 20 stone and then basically, you know, got therapy, got my life back on track, and I was like, I want to lose weight. So looked up, best place to lose weight, jump rope came on top. I basically just picked up the rope and started skipping. Literally I've skipped every single day since June 15th of last year. So it's coming up to a year now. So basically, yeah, I love it. And we were just saying it's like meditation for me. It's like I can just get that rope and like I'm in my own little world. I can just put my tunes on and just like freestyle and just do whatever.
Yeah, that's it. Because a lot of the time I'll just have my headphones on. I'll just go to like a little quiet area of the gym and I'll just train. You can really get into a zone. And when you've got that meditation aspect, when you've got that mental exercise as well as the physical, it's just a sweet spot.
Don't you feel like afterwards, like even though your heart's pounding, you can just kind of like...
You chill.
Yeah, you just feel like you've just been to a spa or something.
What's the longest you found yourself skipping in any one session?
I did about an hour.
Yeah. And it just flies by.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes I'm like, oh, I'm a bit tired, and like I might stop and grab a bit of water
for a second, and then start again. That's wicked, man. You know what? This guy's a huge inspiration. You have to see this guy's progress. Check him out. This guy, as he says, he skips every day. You've skipped every day since
June 15th or 10th, one of those days.
June 15th. Check him out. He's gonna jump leaps and bounds. I just know it.
Spin round. And I'm here with Mimi at Mimi U.
Hello.
How are you? She's come all the way from France today.
Yeah.
Well, tell the people, make sure you check her out. She's skipping all the time.
Oh, that's really kind.
Super fluid. Like she skips like liquid. It's just so smooth. Tell the guys about your jump rope journey.
Well, I've come from Paris to come and see Rushi for the Elevate Expo. Yeah, it's right here. Hasn't seen me yet, but in a few minutes.
Busy man.
And I'm meeting Glenn, first in a lifetime as well. So happy, so honored.
It's great.
Really
it's
humble.
It's great. I mean, it's just such a great buzz. Like, the thing I find with the jump rope community is everyone's just so positive. Right?
Yes.
And it's just these two, they actually met up recently.
Legend as well. He's a legend as well.
How was the trip to France? You met up in France.
Yeah.
Was it France, Paris?
No.
You met up with Dan from Jump. How was that?
It was amazing. Really amazing. Dan is a really, really great guy as well.
Yeah. It's cool, man. It's cool. It's just about seeing people getting together, getting the ropes, and getting to work. Okay. I'm getting tired. My hand is getting tired now because I should have put the phone on this tripod.
Yes,
but anyway, be sure to check out Mimi at Mimi UR Tango below, and of course Deck as well. Two people who love the jump rope game, and yeah, lots of inspiration and good vibes. Check
and
it out.
The legend himself, RopeRage.
Three, two, one.
The first time you looked at it, you saw 20 seconds and you're like, oh my days.
Why did you do it with your legs crossed?
You get up one.
Because it's easier.
Come on, big guy.
Activities, we did workouts. We didn't just walk, you know. We took part in stuff.
That's it, we didn't just walk, we took part in stuff. We did a lot. It was a fun event, man. It was good buzz.
A lot of innovative stuff.
Yeah, some wacky ideas.
There's some things that you guys are going to see in a couple years that came from this expo.
Yeah, a lot of futuristic stuff as well. Speaking of which, that's a f***ing Ferrari right there. I know it's not a Ferrari, I don't know what it is. Is it a Tesla?
I don't know, but I haven't seen it before.
It's something flashy and vroom vroom.
It is.
What is it? It's a Lexus.
Newton, a Lexus. 500.
It's probably one of them. Anyway, yeah, so Elevate was cool. Saw some familiar faces, obviously meeting up Rashu, who did his first expo. It was great to see the whole Rush Athletics team. Super buzz. Everyone's just a bit tired now, man. Just want to get back, get some food. It's funny because initially I planned to get to the gym after this event, but that's a myth now. What's wrong with this? Okay, we're back online. Alright. So yeah, we've got a bunch of stuff that we've put together in video form. I don't know how we're gonna put it all together. There's so much to do, but we'll figure it out. The video editing process is gonna be long as fuck, but it has to be done. So yeah. That's about it. I'm just hungry. My throat's dry as f***. I need to eat.
2 hours later.
Some food. Just a couple of dudes. A couple of girls. This is good life, man. Tell me.
It's good life, man.
This is all you really need, man. Just a couple of guys, some food, and a couple of...